Sweet. Well, the roof idea is pretty cool. Badass. But I can't do anything until I get my doors out. Because I have to go from the front to the rear. No sense putting the rear on if I don't have any doors to line up with. I made these frames out of 1x1 065 wall. They're welded to 3/16 plates. I actually made them inside the door skin, so they're a perfect fit. You can snap the whole door skin onto that thing up there. I did make hinges, but they were kind of cheesy. I was trying to get shapes to start with. This is all original steel right here. The A-pillar inside the door has a piece of pressed 3/16 plate. That bracket is factory. Everything else is homemade. I was thinking windows and stuff, so I put a track in it, and I had actually could have made it work, but I don't need windows. I don't need stinking windows. So that hinge with the weird shape is a pattern. And these hinges that I made. Hold on, I'll see if I can swing it out here. See how loose they are? It's just a pattern. This one's got one too. The quarter inch pins that pull out when you have two hands. They fit good and everything, but I didn't realize when I was making them, they were too thin. And it doesn't close in the right location. I have like a quarter of an inch gap, so I'm going to take those off. Now, I didn't cut the length of these arms because they're going to have to be matched on the A-pillars on the car itself with the firewall, but I've got to make hinges from scratch. And you, of course, your top pin has to be lined up with your bottom pin, so that's a good centering sampler, or what do you call it, like pattern. So I got to get this door done. This one has the frame in it, so it's nice and heavy. That one, the frame's right there, and the door is right here. But I'm going to get them all down after I clean off the back of the car so I can work there like a bench. All right, quit talking about it. Let's do it. That was a pretty good patch, huh? Okay, I'm going to try to slow down. I'm used to the 10-minute rule on YouTube where I have 10 minutes and then my video shuts off. These are the hinges I made. Now, the factory screws were flatheads. I just used them because they line up. Of course, those aren't factory. This is 3/16 plate. That's a hinge I made. Really sloppy. But it actually lines up and would work. Unless you open the door and it falls. These are just cheap quarter-inch pins. The brackets. But I need this stuff for measurements. And I got to keep it level. But this is the factory pressed-in frame. That's actually a switch that would turn on, I think it was the interior light. Imagine that, 80 years old and they had an interior light. That's factory. This is factory. Everything else is homemade. And like I said, a couple quarter 20 bolts on the end. And this is eighth inch steel. I had actually made a door frame identical to the original out of eighth inch. And that's 3/16 plate, all tapped quarter 20. And that's my bear claws I finally get to use. Now this is the door lock, and that's the release, of course, so if the door is locked, unlock the door, and there goes your bear claw on the floor. Close your door. Click, click. But came out really nice, and I did them both at the same time, and they're done. But if I take these screws out, I can pop this whole frame right out of this door skin. The interior was actually, I think I sandblasted it probably. And I didn't have a paint gun at the time. I brush painted it. So it's pretty thick. Brown Rust-Oleum. This is where I did the tack, 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 and I put in that panel. And it actually looks really good on the outside. In here, not so much. But this is where the wood and the nails were. It's all gone. I might add some support from here up to here. And lip it and tack that to that, but this whole thing's going to be covered anyway by that roof section. As far as putting windows in it, I don't think so. I could. We'll see. But it all depends what it's like when I get there. But what I got to do now, I got to make them hinges. Because until my doors are hinges, have hinges, and this is an aluminum pattern. So my doors have hinges and the holes are drilled and tapped. See the notch for the hinge? I can't really go back to the body and start hacking roofs up. But that's 3/16 plate. Car's very heavy. And I don't care. Compared to what it was a big doily. It weighed nothing. And that is secure. So, hinges, I gotta take all that stuff off and mess with it and draw. I use CAD programs to map everything out. Because it makes it easy. You make one, you can mirror it, make another, make a drawing, make another drawing, you know what I mean? But it's very easy. So I'm gonna take those off and play with them. I gotta mark them before I take them off. And I only have two hinges because I cut my roof off. I cut my windshield down 3 inches, and I'll show you, because I just found that little part. What did I do with it? How did I throw it up in the car? I was going through all my metal. Here it is. It went under the car. That's how much I cut off my windshield. If I had to put this on here, it would go there. I think it was 3.5, 4 inches. I forget. But I went by what looks good. See the crown and the cap, and then the body line turns. All right, let's get at it. Well, the hinges are out. This is the passenger side, so I put, you know, passenger bottom, passenger top, pointing up. I've got to recreate this stuff. It was a neat idea, but it was too thin. It had to be quarter inch. This is the roll lock trick. 3M roll lock, worn one, holding on a cutting wheel on an angle head grinder. Works good as you've seen, changes in about 2 seconds. None of this getting 2 wrenches crap. Gotta take a flathead nut that's stripped off the end. Just twist the roll lock, comes right off, put a new one on. Pretty cool, works the balls.